Good afternoon, friends, and welcome to this interaction. We are here today to talk to you about one specific aspect, which is the steps being taken by the administration to facilitate and accelerate the process of issuance of domicile certificates. You're all aware that the government had notified the Jammu and Kashmir grant of domicile certificate procedure rules on the 18th of May in order to prescribe the procedure for issuance of domicile certificates. And you're also aware that as per the amendments in the Jammu and Kashmir Civil Services Decentralization and Recruitment Rules, a domicile certificate is now the basic eligibility condition for appointment to any post under the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. We have spoken to you and explained on many occasions in the past how these rules are simple, how they provide for a simple, clear-cut, time-bound procedure for the issuance of domicile certificate so that nobody is put to any inconvenience. And also how there are time limits, there are provisions for appellate authorities, and how the appellate authorities have both revisional and suo motu powers. We have also made provisions that applications for grant of domicile certificates can be submitted physically or electronically, and that there is an electronic provision and a portal for issuance of these certificates electronically as well. Erstwhile permanent resident certificate holders, in whose favor the former PRC certificate had been issued by the competent authority before 31st of October 2019, are eligible for issuance of a domicile certificate on the strength of the PRC document alone, and no additional documentation is required. Similarly, for Kashmiri migrants, there is a simple procedure and they can get a domicile certificate either on production of a PRC or the certification of registration as a migrant. And we have also opened a special one-time window for all bona fide displaced persons who had migrated but who had not registered, and enabling them to register with pre-designated authorities for the purposes of issuance of domicile certificates. The government undertook a detailed review of the situation, particularly with regard to pending applications, time taken for issuance of applications, and on the 25th of August, it issued an SRO 263, further simplifying the process for erstwhile PRC holders, whereby the time for issuance of these certificates was reduced from 15 days to 5 days, and it was further ordered that for holders of permanent resident certificates, no additional inquiry would be required, and that a domicile certificate would be issued simply on the strength of the availability of a PRC certificate, thereby simplifying the process further. This has considerably accelerated the process of issuance of certificates to holders of PRC, which is the erstwhile permanent resident certificate. And the administration is open to further reducing the time so that all those in need of these domicile certificates can be provided the same with the minimum possible difficulty and in the fastest possible time. We have been reviewing the process regularly. the process of issuance of certificates is picking up rapidly. Over 12.5 lakh domicile certificates have already been issued, and practically all of them have been issued to those who were erstwhile permanent residents or holders of permanent resident certificates, including, of course, Kashmiri Pandit migrants and others. The process of issuance of certificates will be further accelerated, and the issuance will be monitored to ensure that that dependency is brought to the lowest. And as I said, of the 12.5 lakh certificates issued so far, almost 99% or more than 99% have been issued to erstwhile PRC holders. And in addition, 11,398 West Pakistan refugees, 415 members of the Valmiki community, 10 members of the Gurkha community, and of course, 12,340 registered migrants have also been issued domicile certificates. Thank you very much. If there are any questions on this, we are happy to take.
Sir, will these domiciles be... Will there be...
My apologies. To my right is my colleague who is the Principal Secretary Revenue, Mr. Pawan Kotwal. So, as the Principal Secretary Revenue, he is the overall coordinator. So, you can address your questions.
Sir, will these domiciles be added to the voter list, number one? And second is there any deadline fixed by the government about filing and getting these domiciles?
See, the answer to your query is, that if you go through the whole, you know, the legal backing or the legal provision governing this present domicile certificate, it clearly says that it has been issued under the Decentralization Act.
I will answer only one question, क्योंकि आपने मुख्तसर सवाल पूछा, taking the liberty to answer in Urdu. देखिए, पहले हमने 15 दिन का समय दिया था इश्यू करने के लिए. फिर जो मैंने आपसे अभी अर्ज की, हमने SRO SO 263 के तहत इस टाइम को घटा के 5 दिन कर दिया फॉर those who are holders of erstwhile PRC, and हमने यह भी कह दिया कि if somebody holds a PRC certificate, then no further inquiry will be required, and he will be issued the certificate only on the strength of this certificate alone. So this time limit for these people is 5 days, and no further inquiry is required. But as I said, if required, if people are still facing any inconvenience, we are open to further.
Sir, I mean to say that this process कब खत्म होगा?
नहीं खत्म, ये application पे है ना, people can keep on applying within आप जब apply करेंगे उसके 5 दिन के अंदर आपको मिल जाएगा.
Doctor sir,
yes.
I was addressing his question firstly. These
I will come to you.
Domicile certificate is issued under the provisions of the Jammu and Kashmir Civil Services Decentralization and Recruitment Act 2010. And the definition of domicile is that any person who fulfills the following conditions, the conditions are covered in the para 5 of the domicile rules, shall be deemed to be domicile of the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Now the important point is, for the purposes of appointment to any post carrying a pay scale of not more than level 4, that is 25,500, that is the level of the government service which is open to the people who are domiciled, which are defined in the act. So it is the purpose is only to facilitate people to apply for posts which are not more than level 4. Yes. Now the point is that, as you said, that will it entitle them for something for more? It is, the purpose is limited, and this is as per the act. So your question is answered there.